Once again, welcome to another class of ED842. This is our fourth lesson, and today we are going to examine computer software. We're going to look at the types of computer software and what you need to do to protect your system against computer virus. So let's go to class.
All right, welcome to ED842 class. You will understand that computer has two main components, software and hardware. The hardware are the visible parts, the tangible parts that you can see, like mouse, the screen, monitor. But the software are the intangible components that you cannot see physically, but they interface with the hardware to execute specific tasks that you want to perform. So we're going to look at computer software and other components related to computer software. And by the end of this lesson, I expect you to be able to explain the meaning of computer software, distinguish between system software and application software, and describe the causes of virus in computer system. Now let's begin this way. Let's look at the computer software. Basically, a software is a set of instructions and documentation that tells a computer what to do at a particular point and how to perform a specific task. Software is usually installed into the computer storage like hard drive to give commands to the hardware to perform specific tasks. And you know, people develop software to describe their processing needs to the computer. The software in turn, see what software does here. The software we operate the computer hardware to perform the task. Meaning that as I'm using my mouse like this, it's not the mouse, okay, that is performing the function, but the mouse will just be there waiting for instruction from the software to perform specific function. So the systems, the software is basically the components that tells the computer, that interfaces with the computer hardware to perform the specific task that you want to perform, that you want your computers to perform. They are the intangible components of the computer that instruct the computer hardware on how to carry out a task. And if you look at this place, you will see different types of software. You see Microsoft Word, you see Windows, you see Java, Excel, and some other things like this. All these software cannot be seen. You don't see them, but you need them for your computer to perform maximally, or for you to be able to use your computer to execute different tasks. So these are the computer software and their critical components of computer system. Now let's quickly look at the types of computer software. Now, generally we have two main types of computer software. We have what we call the system software, and we have application software. In some literature, you will see three types, but generally, we have two main types, the system software and the application software. Let's quickly discuss this. Now, that software that allows you to communicate with the computer is what we call the system software. And one important type of system software is operating system. The operating system enables other software to run properly by interfacing with hardware and with other software. So you need operating system, which is part of system software, to interface with the hardware and other software to execute tasks on your computer system. In other words, they are programs. These operating system are programs that interpret users' program commands that are contained in application software or in application program. Look at this statement now. Interpret, see what they do. Interpret users' programs, commands that are contained in application software. Later on, we are going to examine this application software. But what operating system does is that the commands that are domiciled in these application software or application programs are being interpreted by operating system. And another thing it does, the operating system, another thing it does is to activate the proper hardware circuits and device to perform the processing. So it will interpret the command that you have in the application software and also activate the hardware components that will perform such task that, okay, you are to do this at this point in time. And that is why when you click on your Microsoft Excel, for instance, it's not the mouse that does what is displayed on the monitor. It's the operating system that will tell the Microsoft Word and will interface with the Microsoft Word and also the mouse to come up so that you'll be able to see what you have on the monitor when you click any icon on your computer system. Examples of operating system include the Microsoft Windows, you know, different kinds of Microsoft Windows. We have Mac OS, then we have iOS that you all know, and even the Android that you have on your mobile phones are all examples of operating system. Quickly respond to this class activity one before we continue. Now, welcome back. Let us proceed to application software. You know, I told you that we have two types of computer software. We have system software that I've just explained now. Then we have application software. The application software are basically the programs created to perform specific tasks. The specific tasks as desired by the users. So if you, depending on the nature of your job, you need some things to be carried out at a point in time. So the software that will help you to achieve that is what we call the application software. They are the software that are specifically created to meet the needs of a specific group of end users. And that is why application software are usually called end user programs. They are programs created specifically to meet the user's needs, like online research, taking notes, graphic designs, and so on and so forth. And if you look at this program, you will see the relationship between the hardware, and the operating system. For instance, the operating system interfaces with the hardware and also interfaces with the application software. You will see this. And also the application software interfaces with the operating system and the user. This is the user. This is the user, you, and what you want to do. So you need to understand this relationship between the hardware, the operating system, the application software, and the user. Let's look at the types of application software. We have word processing software that is, for example, that is used for typing, printing, and all types of documents, e.g. Microsoft Word, WordPerfect, Google Docs, and some other things like that. Another example is the spreadsheet management software, like Excel. Excel is an application software that can be used to achieve to execute specific tasks in an institution. Then we have graphics, and graphics is used for producing pictures, objects, sketches, etc. Example, we have CorelDRAW. CorelDRAW, not everybody uses CorelDRAW. You will see that all these types of software do not necessarily come with computers. You need to install them. Okay, depending on your need, you need to install them. That means they are the application software. They are not for everybody, depending on what you want to do. And we have multimedia software also. This is a software which is able to play, create, as well as record images, audio, or even video files. We have examples like Adobe Photoshop, we have Audacity, we have Windows Movie Maker, we have Camtasia. Then let's quickly look at the computer virus, because as you are using your computers and you are taking note of the software and the hardware component, there are some programs that can destroy the computer system, especially the system software on your system. And these are called the computer virus. This is a program that affects other programs in the computer without your awareness. They will just affect. Okay? You will see here. There are many programs here. And this, the virus here, is affecting the component internally without you taking note of it as a user. In other words, the computer virus is a set of coded instructions that comes into the computer through a foreign disk or network. When your computer is connected to the network, it can be affected by a virus. When you use foreign disk or foreign storage device like flash drive, it can be affected by computer. Now, the first thing it does, that is the computer virus, is to attach itself to critical files, then replicate and spread through the whole system. So it will attach itself to the critical files and it will be multiplying. That is what it means by it replicates. It will multiply and it will spread. And as it replicates, it spreads to the whole system. And it might eventually cause the breakdown of the computer system. Now, we have different causes of computer virus. First is by allowing other user or by allowing others to use their storage device on your system without scanning. If you use foreign storage device like flash drive or memory cards on your system without scanning, it might cause computer virus to affect your system. The software piracy, that is illegal duplication of software, might transfer a virus from one disk to another. Not all the software that you see online that can be easily installed on your system. You install some software and you take virus into your system, and that may be disastrous. Another thing is when a computer is connected to the network, it stands the chance of contacting virus. Then how do you prevent this? For instance, immunity of system against virus with antivirus program. It's important that you have antivirus in your system. There are different kinds of antivirus that you can use. Then ensure that you have antivirus in your system to scan, especially to scan foreign storage devices on your system before using them. Then any borrowed storage device should always be scanned for virus with antivirus program before use. That's important. You don't just collect flash drive and put into your system without scanning. Then you should prevent dust, okay, as much as possible in the computer room or from entering your laptop anywhere. These are the ways you can prevent virus from affecting your computer. And it's important that you take note of all this so that your hardware and software components of the system will be protected. You need to remember, your system contains a lot of information. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next class.